John with Mechanical Pros. I'm here with Quentin, and we are going to be talking about VRV4 condenser fan driver boards. What air codes would pop up if you need to dig into your condenser fan driver board?
Sure. So you might see an E7 or an H7, which would be like outdoor fan motor abnormalities. You might even see something related to communication amongst the inverter boards, one of those type of error codes.
Okay.
The first thing that you're going to want to do, naturally this board is going to be within the module. We have it set here on the table for simplicity's sake to show the checkout procedure, but there's going to be a little green LED light that says HAP. You're going to want to make sure that that light is flashing for one, but it also needs to be flashing steady, just like this. Very slow flashes. You don't want to see erratic flashes on that HAP light.
Okay.
The next thing that you're going to want to do,
and that, show me again where that light is going to be.
Right there.
Okay.
It's like a little diode LED.
Gotcha.
So it's not going to be extremely bright.
So you only see it if it's powered up.
That's right. Gotcha. That's right. So in order to check this thing out, the first thing you're going to do, turn the module off, wait a few moments for everything to de-energize, and then you want to break out your meter. You're going to want to set it to audible tone resistance.
Yeah.
And you've got a little fuse right here. Check your meter leads, make sure that everything rings out, and check that fuse. So we know that fuse is good. The next check that we're gonna do is the diode check. So we're gonna set our meter to diode test.
Okay.
You're gonna notice that you have a couple of terminals here. You've got P terminals and you've got N terminals. Then we have the actual connector for the condenser fan motor itself. So I like to start with my red meter lead on one of the P terminals. And just kind of stick it in place there, let it rest. Take your black lead, go to the U terminal. Well, it popped out already. Want to go to the U terminal? We got OL, the V terminal, OL again, and the W terminal.
Okay.
Got OL again. Now we're going to take that red meter lead out and bring it over to the N terminals. Just pick one, stick it in there. Same thing. We're going to go U. Notice we have 0.4 volts DC. V, 0.4 volts DC, and then W, 0.4 volts DC. Now we're going to reverse the roles of the leads. We're going to take black, we're going to stick it in one of the P terminals, red meter lead to U, 0.4 volts DC, red lead to V, 0.4 volts DC again, and then our final terminal, terminal W, 0.4 volts DC there. Take our black meter lead out. Going to move it over here to the N terminals, and now we should see OL on all three of these terminals. So we're going U, we have OL, V, we have OL, and then W, we have OL. So by this check, we know that the diode bridge is okay on this particular fan driver board. If you do find yourself with a defective fan driver board, one thing that I need to mention is you need to get the paste that Daikin sells that goes on the back of this little heat sink here.
Okay.
And then that will be applied to the back of this board. Make sure not to get it all over everything. It can get kind of messy.
How hard is it to get that paste?
Not extremely hard.
Can you just use any paste or is it specific?
Off the record, you can use whatever the hell you want.
Okay.
But get the Daikin paste. It comes in a little plastic baggie.
Yeah.
Apply it to the back. Put your board back on the heat sink there. Bolt it down. Put everything back together.
Okay.
You're ready to rock and roll. So this is generally a test that you're going to conduct after confirming that the condenser fan motor checked out okay. You know, it's not extremely common for these to fail.
So
it is a good check.
So this here is powering and controlling the condenser fan speed.
That's correct.
Okay.
That's correct.
And so these VRV is so efficient that you're ramping up your compressors, you're ramping up your air speed, you're ramping up your blower motors inside, and also your everything is variable.
That's correct.
Yeah. And so super quiet, super efficient, but you know, you get to learn these types of things. How did you figure this out? Is it in the manual?
I have not seen this particular checkout procedure in the manual.
Okay.
This one was just kind of a trial and error. We figured this one out.
All right. So this is top secret, proprietary. You think that's funny? All right.
I think it is. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
I haven't seen it in the manual. I've read this thing a few times. Maybe I've missed it, but this is usually my nightly reading, and I haven't seen it in the VRV4 manual.
Okay.
It may be tucked in there somewhere, but they do tell you to look at the HAP light, but I don't know about the, I haven't seen the checkout procedure on the actual board itself.
And if this thing checked out bad, you just need to get a new one.
need to get a new one.
Right.
So each fan motor has a specific part number for the fan driver board. So whenever you flip that control cabinet down, you're gonna notice that they have different part numbers. You have two fans, you have two fan driver boards. They are not interchangeable. These are specific. So you can't have two of the same part number. So okay. Make sure that you get the right part numbers on those.
Okay. All right. And how many times do people probably forget the paste?
That's the most common thing that we run into with contractors whenever they've replaced this board or the compressor inverter board, is the lack of applying the paste to the back.
Yeah.
That's the heat transfer paste that allows that heat to be rejected into that heat sink. So
yeah, and you don't have to use a Daikin paste, do you? You can use any paste.
You can use a silicone-based paste.
Yeah. All right. Very cool. Thank you, Quentin. Hit that like, hit that subscribe, and we'll see you again back on Mechanical Pros.